two chopsticks holding it together. How stringy that is. Look at those patties. Oh my gosh.
Smells good.
Good?
What's up everyone, I'm Chris. We've got Steph behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are here in our home and native land, the beautiful country of Canada. If you didn't know, there's not a whole ton of street food available in this country, especially in the winter time. So today we're gonna try something new and take on the Great Canadian Burger Challenge here at the Canadian Brewhouse in London, Ontario. Now there's nothing more Canadian than what we're about to eat, and by we, I mean me. So let's head inside and see what I'm up against. Come on. So here we are at the Canadian Brewhouse waiting for our Great Canadian Burger Challenge burger. And look at this cutlery. Little hockey stick and a golf club there. Really cool.
So Canadian.
And look at that. The serviettes. Hockey jersey. This place is truly Canadian. So I've done a few food challenges in my day. A giant Korean pork cutlet, a giant bowl of ramen, 72-ounce steak, and my record in these challenges? 1-2. So I'm hoping to go 500 with this challenge here today.
Here's your burger challenge.
Wow, thank you very much.
You are so welcome. Good luck.
Thank you. Oh wow, look at those flags. Amazing. So here we have our Great Canadian Burger Challenge here, and this looks like a lot of food. So we have 6 Canadian beef burgers here, 6 ounces each, with all the fixings. Looks like there's bacon there, cheese. Oh my gosh, look how stringy that is. And of course, what's considered to be Canada's national dish, a large bowl of poutine here, which consists of French fries, gravy, and Canadian cheese curds. Wow, that looks rich. Oh, it just smells amazing. So I have 60 minutes to finish all of this, and I get a free t-shirt as well as the meal for free. So I don't know, I'm feeling pretty confident. I think I can do this. It looks like a lot of food, but I think I can do it. I'm pretty hungry today.
You got this.
All right, let's start the timer. Beautiful Sarah here is gonna hit the timer. Okay.
Yep, here we go.
Woo! Okay, let's get going. Thank you, Sarah.
Thank you.
Wow, so first of all, I love the flags as well, but let's get a try of this poutine here. Look how stringy that is. Look at that. Oh. Delicious stringy cheese curds. Mmm. Wow. Those cheese curds, you've never had a cheese curd before. It's almost like squeaky mozzarella cheese, but mmm. That is tasty. The gravy is nice and rich as well. Mmm. Mmm. Okay. I don't even know how to. Chopsticks holding it together. Okay, I think I might just go, wow, look at that. Look how cheesy that is. So we have a burger there, all the bacon as well. Maybe I'll save some of that bacon for some of the other slices. Okay, let's take down some of this burger first. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be a messy one. Cheers. Ooh. Mmm. Mmm. So juicy, the patties. Look at that there. Oh, mmm. That's actually a delicious, delicious burger. Mmm. So much cheese on it.
So much meat.
Oh. The bacon, nice and crispy as well. Mmm. Oh. You can just see the thickness of those patties though. Mmm. Pickle. Mmm. The first two patties? It's pretty heavy. It's a lot of patty. Mmm. It is super tasty though. It's not really that greasy and oh, just really tasty. We'll see how I feel in about 20 minutes.
But we're at 2 minutes 45.
Oh, all the lettuce and onions are on the bottom of the burger actually.
Looks really good. It looks like a really good burger. I feel like this is a bigger burger than you would get normally as you just ordered any old burger here. And I think they definitely beef it up for you.
I think so, because like, look at those patties. Oh my gosh. With other food challenges I've done, we only had like 10 or 15 minutes, so I have an hour to do this one. So I think this one's doable. Bacon is so crispy.
Two patties, pretty much done.
That's a big two patty burger I just had. Oh man. Oh wow.
That's the cheese.
I'm gonna put that here. Oh my god.
Those patties are like a steak.
Okay. Oh man, these patties are thick. These are Costco fries.
Are they really?
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
So the world record holder for this challenge, it's a popular UK YouTuber called Beard Meets Food, and he did it in 7 minutes and 58 seconds. Just to give you a gauge of how fast that is,
8 minutes, 58 seconds.
Oh, 8 minutes, 58
so,
seconds. Okay.
You still got a minute. You still got a minute.
Still got a minute?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
You got a minute to finish it all. That's no big deal. You can do it.
Where did this mushroom come from? Pretty good mushroom. Oh. This is a lot of burger. It's a lot of food.
I feel like those are more than 6 ounce burgers.
3 burger patties down. Oh man, there's so much cheese on these.
So much.
Just over halfway done the burger. Feel a little full.
More than half, we've almost had 4 patties. There's only 2 patties left.
Okay.
So that's not bad, that's not bad. You're doing well. Smells good.
Good? I wish you could have some.
Oh, me too. Look at all that bacon. Oh my gosh. All those cheese curds.
Oh, so many cheese curds.
I'm so jealous, but like, we really can't.
No cheating.
No, I was gonna say, I was looking for the words there. I was like, we really can't affect the chances of winning here, so I'm just gonna have to back away.
No cheating. Whew. This is a lot more food than I thought. These burger patties are pretty big.
They're so big.
Got plenty of time.
Yeah. These are some thick, thick burger patties. 4 patties done. 4 patties done.
Cheering them on so hard.
Maybe I should start eating some of this. Oh.
Couple poutine bites.
This definitely tasted a lot better earlier.
About 17 minutes ago.
This poutine's a nice change though, I must say. These fries are heavy. The starch is always what kills you on these challenges. So this is how much burger I'm left with. This is like a regular sized double patty burger now with the lettuce on top or on the bottom, I guess. Oh my gosh. Still juicy and dripping. This is so heavy. Little iced tea to help get it down. Whew. Okay, we're a third of the way there. Oh my gosh.
20 minutes down.
Can I tell you something though? I really don't want any more of this burger. If it was just a poutine, I'd be okay. I'm kind of sick of the burger now.
Really slowing down here. Things are getting slow.
Oh, lettuce.
Nice little vegetable there for you.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Oh.
Like we said before, if you've never tried a cheese curd before, they are a very dense, rich cheese melted in gravy is just something on a whole other level. Look at that.
Oh. Usually I love cheese curds. There's like a pound of cheese on this burger too.
So much cheese, so much meat, so much everything. Everything was in excess with this burger.
Whew. How is there still so much burger left? I don't know.
So we just passed the 28 minute mark.
28 minutes? So we're not even halfway yet.
No.
That lettuce is really good. How are you feeling, Steph?
I'm actually feeling pretty hungry, I must say, because watching you eat all this food, and it just smells so good, I'm pretty hungry. 36 ounces of beef, plus all the cheese, the fries, the poutine.
And the flags.
And the flags.
No, just kidding.
Which is about, I think they said in total 4.5 pounds of food, did we say? That's a decent amount of food. It's a decent amount of food for one person to consume. And I think you are taking it like a champ. So, we have just passed the 30-minute mark, halfway. You're doing great. So good. I mean, 36 ounces of beef is a lot of beef. And you've almost actually eaten all the burgers, so I'd say you're doing very, very well. And I have so much faith in you that you are going to beat this challenge.
It's not the burger that is the problem at this point.
It'll be that
big bowl of poutine.
That big bowl of congealed.
And it's cooled down
gravy,
too.
Yeah, gravy and cheese and fries.
This still feels like it's like 2 pounds of burger. Oh my gosh.
Oh. Oh my goodness. Killing it. Just killing it.
Just gotta take it slow now. Got about maybe one full patty of burger left.
You put a big dent in that poutine too.
Yeah, a big dent, but there's still so much left.
It actually smells so good.
Not to me anymore. Every bite of the burger, it just gets harder and harder. So close. A new strategy. Take a big bite instead of a little bite.
He's almost finished the burger, which I think he can definitely do in the next 17 minutes or so. That poutine though is looking like it might be a struggle. It's definitely gonna be the hardest part of this, I think, but I definitely have faith on the burger. I have faith on the poutine. He's gonna do it, he can do it. Camera's overheating.
Oh no!
But we're doing it, we're doing it. Burger's almost done.
Just under 15 minutes left.
Okay, all right.
Oh, I know, yeah.
You're doing good, you're doing good.
Who would have thought that a little bite of burger would be so much food? So painful to eat. I feel like a big lump of cheese curd.
Let this be lesson to you kids. Don't try this at home.
Try it here at the Canadian Brewhouse in London, Ontario.
Oh, things are looking good. Just a few bites of burger left. Okay, that burger though was seriously like this tall. It was insane. It was insane.
It was big.
It was really big. Oh. You're doing such a great job.
One bite to rule them all.
Done.
How much time do I have left
burger,
to finish this?
Burger's done. You have about 4 minutes and 10 seconds, approximately, to finish the whole entire poutine.
I must say, I will have to throw in the Canadian flags. I don't think I can eat the rest of this.
Oh my goodness.
It's a burger challenge, so I ate the burger at least.
You did,
so
you did. Burger challenge, you ate the burger. That's a huge win.
Turns out, I think we should stick to street food. I don't think massive burgers and Canadian poutine in a large quantity is quite for us. But who knows, you might see us attempting another one in the future.
You still have a minute and a half to eat all that poutine.
You do, a minute and a half.
I don't know if that's gonna happen. Come sit for the last minute.
Last minute, share it together. I think you've done fantastically.
Ooh. Yeah.
I know for a fact I wouldn't have got nearly anywhere that close. And actually, because this is quite a rounded bowl, like there's not actually that much left there.
There's a lot of poutine, huh?
But what I'm trying to say is that like you did so well with it.
Thank you.
You've done such a good job.
I'm proud of myself that I finished the burger at least.
I'm very proud of you that you finished
those
the burger.
Those patties were...
Like I said, that burger was about this tall. It was massive.
That's
massive,
not a McDonald's burger, that's for sure.
No. No.
No. My fingers smell like burger.
I bet your whole entire body's gonna smell like burger for like the next day.
Oh. You know what? Challenge defeated me. Guess here we are.
That.
Oh.
Turn it.
Oh,
an hour.
It's okay, you tried. You did good.
So
I finished
close,
the burger.
So
I really
close,
wanted
yeah.
to try and finish the burger.
Yeah.
The poutine's the hardest part, I would
it
say.
Is.
It creeps up on ya. It's really filling, like thick with all the cheese and the gravy, but you did
thank
good.
You.
Good attempt.
Oh.
Well done, Chris.
Whew.
I think
when's dinner?
I was gonna say, I think you're gonna be on a break for eating for the next couple of days after that. Eating enough meat for the whole week.
So, as it turns out, the Great Canadian Burger Challenge is in fact a challenge. Challenge accepted, but ultimately failed, so no t-shirt for me. But we were speaking with the bartender and he actually told us that he's never actually seen anyone finish the burger since he's been working here. So that's good enough for me. Despite not finishing the challenge, this has been an amazing experience here. Special thanks to Jennifer, Lewis, and the entire staff here at the Canadian Brewhouse in London, Ontario. They have locations all around the country, so if you're ever visiting Canada, definitely pay them a visit. Give this burger challenge a try if you're up for it, but maybe just order another one of their Canadian classics off the menu because all the food is delicious. Thanks so much for watching this special edition Hungry to Travel Food Challenge video. Let us know in the comments below if you'd like to see more videos like this in the future. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and make sure you subscribe to our channel to join us on all of our food adventures. We're Hungry to Travel, and we'll see you next meal. No, I can't do it.